I'm Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. In this lesson, we're going to take an in-depth look at the combined guitar trick that easily works between the G major chord and the overlay that's possible with G major pentatonic, all done right here in open position. We're going to learn how to play and use this easy connection trick that exists right within the G chord and scale combination. And once you learn how to exploit this effect, you'll have a new trick that sounds fantastic. But first, before we get started, I have a quick word I want to share with you about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. This lesson is all about the open G major chord and how to use it to build a direct relationship around notes of the G major pentatonic scale. We're gonna get things started by helping you completely understand the relationship between open G major chord shape and the notes within the same fret area as G major pentatonic. I've also composed some guitar lick examples for you that combine the sound and apply a bunch of cool embellishments. Plus, I also composed an application example that goes and takes the chord and the scale and all the techniques we cover and combines them over to the relative minor harmony. So you can hear how this sound crosses over to minor as well. So let's get things started by building the G chord connection that establishes this trick. And the chord that we're going to focus on is, of course, standard open G chord. So this chord is pretty straightforward. You could play it with the fingering I'm doing here, 3, 2, and 4, but I'm gonna suggest doing it with 2 and 1 and 3. And the reason why is because where we're gonna head to after this. You can tell here we've got, you know, the shape on the neck, but we can also look at it in terms of individual notes. We got G, B, open D, open G string there. We got open B string as well, high G on top. And those are the outline notes that encompass also the G major pentatonic. So let's take a look at how G major pentatonic fits over there as well. Now, with the chord outline, you know, you just basically are thinking about, you know, taking in open E into that G on the sixth string, open A into the B, open D into an E, open G into this A, open B can go up to the D note here, open E can travel to a G, and from that setup now from out of the G chord, we can have a full-on G major pentatonic. So the pentatonic scale for G major pentatonic is right within the G major chord. It makes it really easy to start using notes and creating ideas for licks and lines and runs. It works great for fillers. If you're, let's say, going from a G chord to a C or a G chord over to an E minor, you can play a nice filler line that really mixes in quite nice. Let me give you an example of a guitar lick that I put together for the lesson here. It goes like this. So one more time. So I'm just getting in there from open G into the second open string again on that third string. And then I'm going over to second string, doing a pull off there. Back to third string for another pull off, into the fourth string for a pull off, and then down to a B note here on the second fret of the fifth string. And then I can just play into a small G major chord. It's pretty, you know, rudimentary because it's only got the low sixth string G, and then we're adding in an open fourth and an open third string into the mix. So it comes across as really nice, and it all fits in. You can tell they're with that G chord. It sounds really cool. All right, let's take a look at what happens next here when we move on to another type of lick, a little bit more involved. I'm gonna do some new techniques and some new embellishments, and it's a little bit longer. Check this one out. Okay, I'll slow it down a little bit for you. So So with this one here, what we're doing is we're taking into consideration more of the two-note chord aspects, which sound great in this end of the neck around that G chord. And it's kind of highlighting things a little bit too with the sound of the two-note chords. We often call them dyads. If you're from some different parts of the country, you might call them double stops. Some people call them that. But it's just really a two-note chord. It's like an interval, and we can add them in. And we're just pulling notes out of the major pentatonic from G to be able to do that. I'm coming in with a slide two there, with an approach slide on those top two notes. Got some open strings, and then into another two-note chord that's at the second fret and third fret of the third and second strings. And then I open those strings up, then just some pull-offs after that. And then down below on the fifth string, we've got a hammer on, and then a couple of open strings. And then we're just hitting some more two-note chords. On the fourth and third strings, we've got a bar there for the set of twos. So that's an E and an A, and then the G with that D note. Bringing in a low G before we finish into the open fourth and third strings. So it's a really nice sound in there. So these are pretty slick sounding. You probably think they sound a lot like a country and western, you know, kind of an idea, and they do. They definitely bring around that type of an effect. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to show you something else with all these sounds. I have an application assignment here that you can do. I hope you're a Patreon member of mine, because you'll get the PDF handout with all the tab and the music notation, all the extra notes for this lesson. Plus, you're going to get an MP3 jam track as well. And that jam track's going to be super helpful, because that track will allow you to start practicing the piece that I put together for you guys. Now, before I play this piece, I need you to think about something. The piece is using G major chord, and we're going to sit on that chord for four measures, and we're going to play a lick two times on those four measures. The lick itself is two measures long. Then what we're going to do, though, is we're going to transfer over to relative minor, which is E minor. When you're in G major, the relative minor chord that we have for it is E minor. And then we're going to do the same kind of thing with licks, but we're going to target more into the E minor sound. So let's fire up the jam track and find out how all this stuff comes together. Now, you could probably hear the difference between the G major chord transitioning over to the E minor, but there's only one thing you have to do to make all the licks still work. It's all the same stuff. You know, we're still using the same scale and everything. The notes are still there, but we're just targeting at the E when we're going and looking at what's happening for the sound of the E minor chord. We want to target right into the E notes. So safest thing you could possibly do is just hit E notes, you know, just have your phrases either start and end, or maybe just end at least on those E notes, and you're going to sound just fine on those sounds of E minor. Now, keep in mind that all the charts, all the tabs, everything you need to be able to study this lesson is available over on my Patreon. All you got to do is head over to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Over there, you're going to be able to download a handout that's super detailed. It has all the charts. It has everything written out in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it's got a lot of extra notes to really help you zero in and fully understand how all this stuff is operating. All the diagrams are in that handout and so forth. Plus, you also get the MP3 jam track, which is great. You know, I think when it comes down to hearing sounds and playing against sounds with jam tracks, that's where it all really comes together, because the jam track helps like almost situate what you would have if you had a band going on with you. Maybe, you know, if you're jamming with guys, it's really going to have everything come together quite nicely for you. And that's important, because bands and jamming and, you know, having everything happening in the moment, that's where all your stuff comes together 100%. And I also think, though, that's really important if you can get together with people. I know it's feels hard sometimes, but if you have some friends that play musical instruments, get together with them and jam a little bit as well. If not, hey, you always got the Patreon. And I've been doing Patreon for a long time. I've got a lot of lessons over there. There's well over 400 lessons on my Patreon. You got to go check it out. It's at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And you know what, guys? If you need help, if you're still kind of at those beginner level stages and you need to be able to get your chops together, understand the neck, know how all this stuff works, what the difference is between major and minor chords, all that stuff, your rhythm, your technique, check out my website. It's a different website than Patreon. They're not affiliated or associated in any way. My website is called creativeguitarstudio.com. Over there, I've got all my courses. If you want to go right in and study beginner, intermediate, and advanced, it's there for you, and it's super detailed. A lot of great information over there. If you wanted to just do fun stuff, I have a lot of electives. You could try some guitar technique, guitar soloing. You could do the acoustic guitar players program. You could do my songs course. I've got a great licks and riffs program for you to check out. Bunch of masterclass stuff, even, you know, music reading, ear training. It's quite a website. It's been online for a long time, and we've had a lot of people go through the site and become very good guitar players from it. Go and check it out. It's creativeguitarstudio.com. And one more time, to get the handout and the MP3 jam track for this lesson, check out my Patreon over at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Learning to play open chord tricks like this will help you get one step closer to becoming the best guitar player that you can be. To learn more, sign up for a free membership today at creativeguitarstudio.com. With a free membership, you'll be able to access all the free lesson material, including a collection of 6 years of YouTube archives, where there are hundreds of videos, PDF handouts, and MP3 jam tracks. Plus, with a free membership, you'll gain access to the Quick Licks program, a 30-lesson course covering guitar licks in all playing styles across all types of scales and arpeggios. When you sign up for a paid membership, you'll get access to my core curriculum, including my beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs. Plus, there's also my elective courses on the site, like acoustic guitar, guitar technique, guitar soloing, ear training, music reading, and many others. Go check it out. You're going to love it. The website is creativeguitarstudio.com. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.